Hi guys, Vikas over here and this is your genius. Guys, in this video, we are going to check out this little SBC over here, that is NanoPi S2. So with a special thanks to Friendly Lech for sending this in, let's open it up. Actually, I have put the link to the Friendly Lech website where you can buy these boards if you want. And you can also check out the different versions or the different variants of this NanoPi boards. So on this box we get one manual that comes with like safety features and all warnings, and as well as the features that is being provided by this S2 board, and getting started like general information like how to boot your OS and all. So let's keep it aside and opening up this pouch over here. Yeah, in an anti-static pouch, here comes the board itself, and it again comes with a heatsink like this over here. So if your processor is running hot, you can definitely put it in. And this comes with these terminals and all, so you can easily fit in. So guys, this measures around 40x75mm. Which is a bit larger than Raspberry Pi Zero, but this comes with a lot of features as compared to Pi Zero. And talking about the processor, this has got Samsung ARM Cortex A9 processor, which can be clocked up to 1.4 GHz with 1 GB of DDR3 memory, which you can see over here. This chip over here, and at the back you get another RAM module. Along with it has got onboard 8 GB of eMMC memory, which you can obviously use to boot your OS from. And coming on to networking, it doesn't get onboard Ethernet, but it does feature onboard Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 4. And for that, you get the antenna connector for wireless connectivity over here at the edge near the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth chip. And on connector side, you get full-fledged USB over here, 3.5 mm audio jack, that is for microphone in as well as audio out, and beside that you get micro HDMI socket, which can be used to hook up a display to the board. And for that you just need micro HDMI to HDMI converter or a micro HDMI to HDMI cable. And on this side you get two buttons that is used for boot and power, along with two LEDs which shows power and activity status. And at this side, you get a micro USB socket that is used to power it up. Along with, it has onboard power management system, which is again software controlled. And on the board, you also get the serial camera and display connector with an added bonus of this connector over here, which can be used to hook up RGB LCD directly. And at the back, you also get a micro SD card socket that you can use to load your OS. And if you are interested to use this board for IoT application on GPIO side, you get 40 pin GPIO header that is compatible with Raspberry Pi, and along with that you get some additional interfaces on the GPIOs like multiple UART and SPI buses along with some other interfaces. Beside that you get a serial debug interface, and in addition to that you also get one ADC interface that you can hook up your analog sensors into if you are like working with some analog sensors. And it has got two inputs which are like limited to voltage level of 1.8 volt, so you have to like take care whenever you are interfacing with sensors, the voltage limit has to be in the range of 0 to 1.8 volt. So that's all for today guys, that's all about the features and the power of this board. Hope in future I'll be coming around more videos around this board for different application and different peripheral interfaces. So if you have liked this video, definitely you can hit the like button, and if you have not subscribed yet, you can subscribe to my channel to get the latest updates. So see you next time with my new video. Till then, goodbye.